Welcome back. Welcome back. Welcome back. Y'all, this is Pastor P. It's been the place to be. And I want to welcome you to the one and only Kiss God Radio on loveradionetwork.com. Love is where it's at. Y'all, it's been some time, but God has been good. He's been real good. I feel like it's been about a month now that I have not been on the air. But I want to say thank you. Thank you for being patient. Thank you for being supportive. Thank you for staying on and listening to the repeats and being blessed by the repeats. You know, repetition is the mother of all learning, right? And so the more that you hear it, the more that it gets in your spirit, the more that we learn and we grow as we go. So y'all, I'm back. I'm back through a trying time. I had COVID-19 for quite some time. And I was down for just about a month, coughing, couldn't breathe. But thanks be unto God who has caused us to triumph, that he has brought me through. And I want to thank God for my wife. My wife has kept me, supported me. I tell you, I don't even know what to really say. She has stood by my side, you know, and whether some people call it crazy or not, but she didn't even wear a mask while she was serving me, making sure I took my meds, getting me to the hospital, and praying over me, giving me great tea. And thanks be unto God that she didn't catch COVID-19. So I am, I love you, sweetheart, and I hope that you're listening, and I appreciate you so very much. I don't know what I would have done without you being there, and so I bless you, and I bless God for you. And I want to say thank you to my family, to VOG, to my mom, my sister, and my big brother, Charlie Rock, Dr. Charles, for keeping me on and doing the repeats and praying for me. Because, y'all, I didn't know if I was going to make it out or not. But God is good. And I just thank God for my sons who was contacting me and praying for me. So I'm back. I'm back with a vengeance. You better believe it. The devil thought he had me, but I got away. And all I could say is, checkmate, Satan. Checkmate. God had one more move. You thought you had me. But God made his move. And Satan can't get me now. And so, y'all, I want to thank you for being on tonight. I want to thank you. I got something very special for you. And we're going to go ahead and dive in and see what God has to say. All right? So let's pray. Father, I thank you right now for your grace and your mercy. Father, take us into this session. For every single man and every single woman will be blessed as they be restored, revived, rejuvenated, and refreshed. Take us high, O Lord, and we thank you for being able to speak into their spirit this evening. In Jesus' matchless name we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. Y'all, I'm feeling good right now. You better believe it. You better believe it. I feel good being in this studio tonight. What you talking about? I'm grateful. I am really grateful. All right. Once again, y'all, this is Pastor P. You're in the place to be for the next 30 minutes, the right place. LoveRadioNetwork.com. Love is truly where it's at. I want you to take love on a go, and I want you to fall in love 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. You could take love with you. How about that? Isn't that wonderful? Some people fall in and out of love, but you can keep love on the go. Love Radio Network is where it's at. Go ahead and download that app. Keep it with you. Download it on Fire Stick. I'm telling you, there's some great things on that app. All right, so let's go ahead and do it. And I'm telling you, your life will never be the same again. The content is wonderful. All right, I'm going to take you on to Daniel, the sixth chapter. Daniel, the sixth chapter. And it's just is like a fundamental or my foundational text, if you don't mind. Again, this is not Bible class, but it is Kiss God. Daniel chapter 6, verse 3. The Bible says here, then this Daniel distinguished himself. yourself above the governors and satraps, because an excellent spirit was in him, and the king gave him thought to setting him over the whole realm. So far, the text. Looking at that verse where it says, because an excellent spirit was in him. Y'all, I was on the plane the other day, and I was flying back into Jersey, and the Lord told me to tell the singles to have an excellent spirit in all that you do. So today's message, tonight's message, this evening, is excellence. There's no other way. There's no other way. Excellence. All right. So we want to talk about that. And I have a couple of notes here, so I'm just trying to bring this up. But the first thing that I want to say is success is based on a comparison with others. Excellence is measured against your own potential. Now, there are some notes that you're really going to want to take, because I'm going to start talking to you the difference about success and excellence. Now, I know this is the year of success, and I know this is the year of achievement, but we want to even go further into that. And I'm going to say it again. Success is based on a comparison with others. Excellence is measured against your own potential. The only comparison that I should be making is with myself. See, a lot of times you compare yourself with other people. You compare yourself with other people's vehicles, where other people live at, other people's relationships, especially on Facebook. You know, you start looking at other people's relationships. You want to do what they're doing. You want to start taking the pictures. You know, you want to start doing TikTok. You want to start dancing. So you start comparing yourself again with others. You know, you start saying, you know, can I do that? Should I do that? You know, their hair is better than mine. Their body is better than mine. The way they talk is better. You know, listen, I'm telling you now, I'm going to say it again. Success is based on a comparison with others. Excellence is measured against our own potential. So the only comparison that I should be making, again, is with myself. Will I be better tomorrow than I am today? How about that? Will I be more thoughtful, more intentional, more purposeful in the future than I am right now? Do my habits, my routines, rituals, and actions match my intention to be better tomorrow than I am today? So the only comparison that I should be making is against my own potential. Now, singles, I want you to really think about that. I really do. I want you to stop, Selah, if I could say, pause, stop, think about that. Okay? I want you to ask yourself again, do my habits, my routines, my rituals, my actions match my intentions to be better than better tomorrow than I am today? So these questions here that I'm asking you tonight, they're the gateway to excellence. Because living a life of excellence is about the fanatical pursuit of gradual improvement. So literally, when I was taking notes on the plane before I fell asleep, God said, improvement, improvement. You've been through a lot. You're going through some things now. And some of you feel like this is the perfect life for you, where you are, you know, where you are right now. But I'm saying to you that there's more, not just success, but excellence. And I want you to understand that in order to get to excellence, there has to be a gradual improvement. Let me give you this formula, if I can. This cord is going in and out. It's the principle of reaping huge rewards from a series of small, smart choices. All right? That's how you get to a gradual improvement when it comes down to excellence. It's the principle of reaping huge rewards from a series of small, smart choices. Small, smart choices plus consistency plus time equals radical difference. You got it? I'm going to say it again. I'm talking about how do I become excellent? When the Bible was talking about Daniel, right? When the Bible was talking about King Darius, seeing something in Daniel. So you as a single, whether you're going for that loan, whether you're going for that job, whether you're going for a community leader, whether you're going out on a date, I don't care what it is. The bottom line is that you go out with the spirit of excellence. I'm not talking about whether or not you have a great car and you're successful, you're making six digits. You know, you could be successful, but you don't have the spirit of excellence. And I think that's what I'm after. I'm really after you having that spirit of excellence, that Daniel spirit, because an excellent spirit was in him that King Darius put him over the governors, put him over the satraps, put him over the whole realm. And then watch this. That's why they wanted to take him out, because he had a spirit of excellence. And I don't care who you're around. Start being around people that have a spirit of excellence, not because of what they have, not because of the material things they have, not because of what it looks like on Facebook, not because of what it looks like on Instagram, not because of what it looks like on TikTok. I don't care what social media portrays. What I want you to understand is how you, my brother, my sister, how you are gradually improving. And one of the things that I said today, because I'm tired of people saying this to me, I'm just me. That's just who I am. Are you improving in any kind of way? You was like this in 88. This is 2022 and you still the same way? Come on. You still tripping. You still bugging. You still got the same attitude. Where is the gradual improvement? Well, let me go back to that. Let me go back to the formula that I just told you. What did I say? It's a principle that reaps huge rewards of a series of small, smart choices. Small, smart choices. Small, smart choices plus consistency plus time equals radical differences. Now, you cannot be satisfied where you are. You cannot be. Don't be. I got it. You reached a goal. Now what? Why not? Why not be satisfied with the attainable goals of success rather than opting for the hard road of continuous but never finished improvement? You just stopped. You cannot live off of yesterday's success. You can't. Brother and sister, listen to me. Listen to me. You cannot live off of yesterday's success. Whether it didn't, I don't care. It didn't work out. The relationship didn't work out. Your children bugged out. The man flipped out. The woman left. You got a divorce. I'm telling you now. You're going to start making small, smart choices plus consistency plus time is going to equal a radical difference. So I'm telling you, why pursue excellence when winning can be had for less? You asking me? All right, I'm telling you. I want you to get to this, because the more that we understand where God wants to take you, you have to yield to the next step of your life. Now, what does the Bible say? The Bible says that the steps of a good man or a good woman are ordered by the Lord. So God doesn't just want us to be successful. He wants us to have the spirit of excellence. Are you with me? All right. So let me say this. Let me make this statement. Excellence is not a gift. Excellence is not a gift. And I want you to write that down. Excellence is not a gift. You are not born with excellence. Excellence is an attitude. So you already see the difference between success, because a lot of people say success or go after success or feel they are successful by what they make, by what they have, by what is seen on the outside. But excellence, it's an attitude. It's an attitude that's generated by a spirit. Excellence is an attitude generated by a spirit. That has to be, now listen to me, it has to be developed. And lately, as I have been reading and watching the news, you know, everyone is talking about the quality control. Everybody is talking about management of quality control, and every company is trying to get to the edge of quality because the market is so saturated with many different types and, you know, products and types of services, that the future is they don't even know what the future is going to be. They don't even know what the new products is going to be. So they are worried about what they have. They're concerned about what they have. But what we have to be is have the mind of excellence no matter what. No matter what the past did, and no matter what's coming in the future, we want to have an excellent spirit now. And the reason why I'm saying that is because the future belongs to those who have the edge on excellence. You got it? You become excellent now in your spirit so that you're ready for what God has for you in the future. All right. Where do I want to go? Okay, so the future, again, it belongs to those who have the edge on excellence in service or excellence in quality, right? Okay. So that's the difference. That's the difference between success and mediocrity. So in the next century, in business, we have to know that it's not about so much succeeding, but what's going to take you further is my excellent attitude. All right, right. Everybody is selling a product. Everybody, you know, supplies a service. But only the few top supply quality, service and excellence, and products. Excellence is divine and defined by your attitude. So that's why when you date, when you go out with somebody, when you're choosing friends, you want to choose friends with a certain spirit. You want to choose friends with a certain attitude. Right? Because excellence, again, is defined by the highest quality. I'm looking for people that have high quality. Oh, yes. I made errors with choosing people in my life that had low quality. Now I'm choosing people now in my life of the highest quality. Got it? In other words, superior standards. So ladies, you don't go out with somebody less than that, less than your standards. Brother, you don't go out with somebody, you don't marry somebody, you don't date somebody that has low standards. I'm talking about extreme quality. That's what we're after. And I see excellence is not just quality, but it goes to the extreme. And finally, excellence is defined as maximum quality. Maximum quality. So this is how we must look at it, because excellent people, they pursue and they conquer. Excellent people are above average. Are you hearing me? Excellent people are above average. Average people complain about things. Excellent people pursue solutions. Listen to me. You know what I tell people? I tell my children that this as well. I eliminate excuses. No. We're not going to keep having excuses. I eliminate excuses. Huh? We go mad. We go make a difference. So I'm going to say this to you. I want you to write that down now. Average people, what do? They complain about things. Excellent people, they pursue solutions. Average people stare at problems. Excellent people pursue solutions. You got it? Average people, they stare at problems. Excellent people orchestrate in the mind. They translate in the speech. And they demonstrate, oh, glory to God, in their life. I'm going to repeat that. That was good, and I hope I should write this down. I'm going to say it again. Average people stare at problems. What are we going to do? What are we going to do, boo-boo? Hey, boo-boo. Y'all remember Yogi? What are we going to do, Yogi? All right, okay. I'm back. Excellent. Excellent people orchestrate in the mind. They translate in the speech. They demonstrate in their life. Forget all of this, what you got to show to people. Forget all this, how you have to be in public. I'm going to say it again and again and again and again and again. Average people stare at the problem. Excellent people orchestrate it in the mind, translate it in speech, demonstrate it in their life. Got it? And another thing, I want to say this to you before my time is up. That was quick. That was quick, Charlie. That was very quick. Let me say this to you. You don't have to ask a person if they are excellence. Have you noticed? You can tell by the way they dressed. You can tell by the way they talk to you. You can tell the way by how they are organized, what's around them. You could tell by the way they order their words in their world. You could tell by how they speak. Excellence is not imposed from the outside, y'all. I'm talking to excellent singles here. My brother, you're an excellent man. My sister, you're an excellent woman. You're single, excellent people. You don't settle for less. Excellence is not imposed from the outside. It is released from the inside. And if you are going to be, man, this is some good stuff. I'm back. If you are going to be an excellent single, and if you're going to inspire other people, other singles, and if you're going to look in that mirror and say to yourself today, I'm an excellent human being. Can't nothing take me down. Nothing bring me down. Can nobody say anything different about me? Yes, I'm successful, but I'm also excellent. What you talking about? You got to have that mindset. And not only that, because people could be successful, right? But they don't demonstrate excellence. It's got to be in your mindset, mindsight. Demonstrate it in life, in your speech, how you talk. You know, people who are successful, they don't read. They just know how to make money. They just have a business, and their business is doing good. But come on. There's so much more than, you know, people who are successful. You know, there are some people that don't even want to be bothered with them, don't even want to, you know, do business with them. Why? Because of the attitude. Excellent people make improvements, not excuses. Boy, that's good. That's good. I know that's good. I know. Come on. I know that's good. Listen, you make improvements, not excuses. That's what I'm talking about. People who are excellent, they know how to lead themselves. And the hardest person to lead, singles, is leading yourself. That's the hardest. Those are the hardest people to lead, is ourselves. You got it. But we got to learn. We got to learn how to encourage ourselves to that excellence, to that excellent place, to pursue solutions. Right? Forget about the obstacles. Go ahead and leap over it. You're going to be challenged, but that's okay. Eliminate the excuses. Don't give in to them. And I truly believe that the more that you begin to conquer this, because every person that I'm speaking to that knows they have the spirit of excellence should know that you don't settle for average. Do not settle for the average. Let me tell you something about average, and I'm gonna let this be. What is 26 after? Listen, because I got a song for you. Let me say this to you. I'm gonna leave this here. Average is the grave in which excellence is buried. Boom. That's why you're not average, because average is the grave in which excellence is buried. And average people strive to fit in, while excellent people strive to stand out. Hear what I'm saying. Y'all, my time is up. Did you get it? My time is up, and I thank you for yours. This is Pastor P, and I want you to join me next week on Kiss God Radio for part two of Excellence. There's no other way. God bless you. Heaven smile upon you. I pray that you go in peace, and may your peace be multiplied. Sally Brock, come back. Take him to the fridge, baby. Hey, don't worry about it. Leave it alone. It gets better. Hope you believe it, but the end of the story will get better. Hey, you can fight for way too long. Hey, better. Gotta keep going. Hey. Just a thought.
not alone. We just gotta be strong. And here we go. Yes and amen. Yeah. He is not a man that he should lie.